morning. Welcome back to another amazing worship experience right here at Dare to Imagine Church. My name is Wallace.
And my name is Crystal. We are beyond excited that you decided to join us today for another worship experience here at Dare to Imagine.
Amen. So as we kick it off and get started, this is your opportunity right now to stop what you're doing and share this experience.
Yeah, so go ahead, share with your family, your friends, and oh, by the way, while you're at it, go to our YouTube channel and subscribe. Click that red button so that you can always stay in tune and abreast of what's going on here at Dare to Imagine.
Absolutely. And we want to, of course, shout out everybody in the sanctuary. You all look wonderful this morning. And then if you're watching online, shout out to you too. Go ahead and drop a comment in the chat. Let us know where you're tuning in from.
Yes. And can we talk about last Sunday?
Yeah.
The all white affair, y'all. It was so much fun. I didn't want to leave.
No, it was really one of my favorite all white affairs that we've had since I've been here at D2R.
Absolutely. From the live music to the food to the 360 cameras.
The jazz band.
The jazz band. I mean, they were, B-side showed up.
they
did their thing. So we hope that you guys have enjoyed it just as much as we did and have gone on our website to look at the pictures of you and your family. All you have to do is go to d2ic.org /events. You can see all of our all white affair pictures and on our Instagram too.
Yeah, and you know, my favorite part was actually the word that Pastor KJ brought.
Yes.
Absolute fire.
Yes.
And that, you know, my bad.
No, you're good. I was like, that it was fire, man. Like, we're like, we gotta talk about it.
Right.
It's so good.
It was, and you can check it out yourself if you again hit that red subscribe button so you can check out the word from last week's all white affair and all the amazing words to come.
Absolutely. And as always, there is just so much going on here at Dare to Imagine. So let's go ahead and jump into our segment called
What's Happening?
All right, y'all. So we are so excited because we are gearing up and preparing ourselves for yet another round of our baptisms here on our Dare to Imagine campus. So we encourage you right now to go ahead and mark your calendars for September the 15th at 7 p.m. That's September 15th at 7 p.m. We encourage all the baptizees to bring your family and friends so that they can witness you getting baptized. And, you know, we encourage you, like we said earlier, to go on our website, which is d2ic.org/events, and so you can see all that's going on here at Dare to Imagine.
Absolutely. And if you are like so many of us, you've missed being at church, being at your church home, we invite you to join us for our National Back to Church Week.
Yes.
Coming up and kicking off on Sunday, September 19th. At our 9 and 11 a.m. services. So again, definitely join us for the Back to Church Week starting that Sunday. Again, go to d2ic.org/events.
Yes. Now, women. Yes, I'm talking to you in the sanctuary and you watching online. On October 23rd, mark your calendars. We are going to have the Women's Level Up Conference here on our Dare to Imagine campus. It is only a $39 registration fee, but that includes food and fun and a Christ-filled time. I said food and fun and a Christ-filled time. And a time to just connect with all the wonderful women we have here at Dare to Imagine. If you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to Sister Kemia at kemia@d2ic.org with any questions that you might have.
All right, y'all. Well, you hear the music, so that means whether you're in the sanctuary or watching at home, it's time to get up out of our seats and worship the Lord.
Let's get it.
Here we go, y'all. Come on, you can clap your hands as we declare that we serve a great and mighty God. Yeah. Hallelujah. Nobody, come on.
Nobody.
Who is like the Lord?
Who is like the Lord?
Nobody say nobody.
No.
Who is like the Lord?
Who is like the Lord?
Nobody, come on.
Nobody.
Who is like the Lord?
Who is like the Lord?
No, nobody.
No, nobody.
No nobody. Here we go.
There's nobody
what can
separate us
from the love of Jesus, yeah.
From the love of Jesus.
He will keep his promise.
He will keep his promise. There's nobody like him. Nobody
let me hear
like
say,
him.
Oh.
Whoa.
Somebody say nobody.
No, 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 nobody.
Who is like the Lord?
Who is like the Lord?
Nobody, come on.
Nobody.
Who is like the Lord?
Who is like the Lord?
Nobody.
No, 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 nobody.
Somebody say, Lord, we declare. Here we go. Lord, we declare. Who can?
Who can compare?
Who would even dare?
Who would even dare?
There is.
There is no one like you.
Lord.
Lord.
Thank you. Trust in
always say,
I will wait on you.
I won't get in a hurry, no.
I will wait on you.
I'm going to wait on you, Jesus.
I will trust in you.
Till I die.
I will trust in you.
Say, I will remain.
Confident in
that I will see the goodness of the Lord. While I'm here in the land of the living, remain. Here we go.
I will remain
confident in this.
Confident in this.
That I see the goodness.
Oh,
Travapalooza, Back to School Bash Book Bag Giveaway. We are so excited to have all the kids here.
Hey, everybody! Come in here ready to get back to school. We want everybody to be able to get back and have a wonderful, safe, productive school year. We know that you all are covered in God, that God is with you.
It was so much fun. And we got pets out. And we got backpacks.
First day volunteering, there's going to be many more, but I'm really enjoying myself and the kids had a lot of fun.
Welcome you.
Amen.
My name is Crystal.
And my name is Wallace. We are so blessed to have you here in the sanctuary and watching online.
Yes, as you can see here at Dare to Imagine, we are always just so busy doing things. And we are always looking for volunteers and people to help us push God's ministry in the right direction.
Absolutely. And you know, I'm seeing a lot of first-time visitors out there, so let's go ahead and clap it up for our first-timers here in the sanctuary.
Amen.
Welcome to Dare to Imagine. If this is your first time, we want to connect with you, so make sure to fill out one of these connection cards front and back. Give it to anybody with some D2I gear on, and we'll just loop you in with everything going on here at church.
Absolutely. And if you are watching online, we encourage you to let us know that this is your first time as well, so that one of our team members can reach out to you so we can get a little bit of information from you to stay connected with you.
Absolutely. So like Crystal said, there's so much going on in the church. We need all of our volunteers to step up and join in and really make everything happen.
Absolutely. Wallace and I love volunteering
we
here
sure
at Dare
do.
To Imagine. So we want you guys to be a part of the team as well. And as we tell you guys every Sunday, we encourage you to go ahead and share this worship experience. All you got to do is real easy, y'all. Drop this link of our streaming in your family group chats, whatever you got to do to get people here on board at Dare to Imagine.
Absolutely. So we're going to kick it off with the rest of our worship service. So let's welcome our very own Pastor KJ.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give it up for Wallace and for Crystal. We praise God for them, and we thank God for those who are visiting with us for the first time in person, or if you're visiting online, we praise God for each and every one of you. I'm just thankful for all that God continues to do in the midst of this COVID-19 season, and I'm thankful for how God is going to use us. Back to Church Sunday is coming up on September the 19th here at Dare to Imagine Church. We want you to invite your family and friends. This is a part of a national effort to help people get back to church. We want you to encourage your family and friends and have them come and to experience Dare to Imagine. We'll talk a little bit more about All White Affair shortly, but I just wanted to share that with you. And we have these little cards. Come on out here, Reverend Ruff. Kevin Ruff, he is our new campus pastor. Let's give God some praise for him. And I'm going to talk about him shortly, but just kind of share with us a little bit about Back to Church and this initiative and what you need to help us get back to church.
Yes, sir. So good morning, everybody. I'm so happy to be on staff here. Looking forward to getting to know you. This initiative is one where we are inviting first-time guests and people who just haven't been in a long time. And so in order to make them feel as welcome as possible and create an unforgettable experience, I need your help. I need people to volunteer. We're going to have an interest meeting today after this service in the conference room down that hall. So if you're interested in helping out and creating an awesome experience for those who will come on the 19th, please meet me in the conference room. Thank you.
Amen. So since I got you up here, amen, give them a round of applause. Amen. Back to Church Sunday. But this past Wednesday, if you watched online, you learn that we are about to go ahead and fully implement the vision that God has given us. We started Dare to Imagine nearly 7 years ago. Matter of fact, this coming December 28, 2021, we will be celebrating 7 years since we had our first worship service. Amen. Come on and give God some praise if you're online. Give God some emoji claps. And part of that vision was to launch other campuses. And one of the things that we needed to do is to get a campus pastor for here. Of course, I'll be preaching and all of that, but I needed someone to help organize things here. And each time we launch another campus, we will put another campus pastor there. And so Kevin Ruff, he's a graduate of Eastern University, of Dallas Theological Seminary, and he started this past week. So can y'all just show some love to Kevin Ruff? Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Reverend, and we're so excited. So let's get ready now to give and to bless God through our giving. I encourage you to give the way that I give, and all you have to do is a text D2I Church app to 77977. Let's give joyfully to the Lord because God has been so good to us.
I know that I win. I know who I am. God wrote it in His plan
for me.
Come on and say, oh,
oh, oh, oh.
My name is Victory.
Everybody ought to say, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh.
Everybody say, my name, say.
Here last Sunday for the all-white affair. Did you have a good time? Yeah. Amen. Let's watch this recap of all-white affair for 2021.
The All White Affair is one of the most outstanding events that I've been at. This is my first time at the All White Affair. It is a remarkable miracle happening. Like, it's so special that I don't want to leave.
Amen. Can y'all do me a favor? Give it up for Max and for Vessel. They did a great job putting that highlight video together. Amen. I just love our teams. I thank God for how God is using us for his glory. And I want you to know that last Sunday at our 11 a.m. worship service, 13 people came down. 12 people came down and 3 joined online. So 15 people joined church last Sunday. Come on and give God some praise for that. And beloved, I'm just so thankful to you and thankful for your support and all that we do. I know this past week has been tough with Hurricane Ida, and we saw the floods take place here in Philadelphia and New Jersey. And we want to be a blessing to those who have been impacted by Hurricane Ida. And that's why our Expand the Vision offering today will go towards helping those who have been impacted. We're going to give half to the Red Cross, and the other half we're going to find a family who needs help. So if you have a nomination for a family that was impacted, please send us an email here at info@d2ic.org, and we'll be glad to help and to bless some of those families. Amen. So let's give now to the Lord. I encourage you to give the way that I give. All you have to do is to text D2I Church app to 77977 and use the category of Expand the Vision so we can help those who have been impacted by Hurricane Ida.
I know my identity. My name is Victory Says.
I know my identity.
My name
is.
Somebody say victory. Here we go.
Victory.
I know
my
giver and for every person, God, who was not even able to give today. God, bless these gifts and multiply them. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. If you're watching online, if you'll go ahead and share this worship experience right now. If you're on YouTube, go ahead and hit subscribe. Or if you're here in the sanctuary and you want to know every time that we go live, every time we share a new video, go right there to YouTube and hit subscribe and to follow us here at Dare to Imagine Church. Let's get ready to usher in God's presence today. Amen.
There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen the sweetest of loves, when my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence alone.
To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Come on, come on. Let's stand.
So let us speak of
the glory
of your presence.
Thank you, God.
Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your touch. Let us experience the glory of your goodness.
It's because they're singing about God's presence. And I want you to know something, that you can have money and not have God's presence. You can have education, and I have 3 degrees, and still not have God's presence. And I don't know about you, but if I had to choose between $1 million and God's presence, I'll take God's presence every single time. Is there anybody who wants to be in God's presence? Come on, let's sing together.
Let us experience the glory of your good. Come on and say it.
Let us become more aware of your presence.
Let us experience
the glory of your good.
Let's bless the name of the Lord. Amen. Come on and give God a hand clap of praise today. Amen. Amen. You may take your seats. We thank God today for each and every one of you. Thank God for His Spirit and and thank God for how he continues to bless during the midst of this season. And so, beloved, I just want to share a few things with you. First of all, if you're glad to be in God's house, come on and bless his name today. Amen. Beloved, as we get ready to expand and to bring many more people to Jesus Christ, because I firmly believe that that's the reason why God has started this church, to help people to come to Christ and then to dare to imagine a better life for themselves and for their families. But I also want you to be safe during this season, and that's why I want to make sure that everybody has been vaccinated. Everybody say with me, get vaccinated. If you're online, put it right there in the chat. Get vaccinated. Under no circumstances should you be walking around on this earth and you have not been vaccinated. I'm thankful to God that we here at this church, that when vaccinations became available, that we partnered with the city and partnered with Rite Aid, and we were able to get over 1,000 people vaccinated. Come on, bless the name of the Lord. But I know some folk are being hard-headed. Amen. And so grandma would say hard head. I'm not going to say what she said because it wasn't Christian, although she was a Christian, but you understand. Amen. So please, please get vaccinated. Wear your mask. It is so important. And we're going to keep worshiping. We're going to keep worshiping. And I'm praying about it right now. I don't want to have to make it a requirement that you're vaccinated to come to worship. But if the Lord says to do so, then I'm going to do it. So go ahead and get vaccinated. I'm giving you fair warning now. Get vaccinated. There's a word today from the Lord. I'm going to read from two scriptures today. Mark chapter 4. And then we'll also go down to Exodus chapter 14. And in Mark chapter 4, begin at verse 35, there you will find these words. It's so good to see my brother John McKnight. I saw him earlier, his family at Wawa. That's my favorite place. If you ever want to find your pastor, you will see him at a Wawa. Amen. Lancaster Avenue, Germantown Avenue, you're going to find your pastor at a Wawa somewhere. Exodus chapter 14 and Mark chapter 4. Let's go to Mark chapter 4 first. And the word says, that day when evening came, he said to his disciples, let us go over to the other side. Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along just as he was in the boat. There was also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern. Somebody say he was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, teacher, don't you care if we drown? He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, be still, quiet, be still. Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith? They were terrified and asked each other, who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him. And then there in Exodus chapter 14, verse 14, the Lord says to them, the Lord will fight for you. You need only be still. I want to talk today in the midst. Amen. Come on, bless the name of the Lord today. I know that we have experienced a storm this past week that has wreaked havoc on our region. But I want to talk, you've heard of storm surges, but I want to talk today about storm praise. Can y'all put that in the chat? Come on, say with me, storm praise. Beloved, there is something going on in our atmosphere. In fact, if you read any type of scientific journals or if you pay attention to any readings about these hurricanes, we are in the midst of an interesting season because hurricanes are going to start to become our norm, particularly around this season. You see, what's happening now, and whether you want to believe it or not, but I do because I believe in science, is that there is a global warming that is taking place. In fact, the global warming is impacting those who live in California, as you begin to see that there are summer rivers that are starting to dry up because of global warming. There are forest fires that are starting because of global warming. And for those of us who are on the East Coast, we need to start to get used to many more storms like hurricanes because of global warming. In fact, a few years ago in one summer when there was Hurricane Harvey and Hurricane Irma and Hurricane Jose and Maria and Nate, I've just been waiting for them to come up with Hurricane Kevin. They ain't got around to my name yet. But they, during that particular season, the phone calls and the emails went to the director of the hurricane research at the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration there in Miami, Frank Marks. And the questions and the emails went to him because the question was, what can we do about the hurricanes? If we can stop the hurricanes, then we won't have to pay all of these billions of dollars to try to fix what the hurricane did. And as these questions came into him, there were different scientists who had different proposals as to how to stop the hurricanes. There were some who said what we need to do, because when you understand how hurricanes work, is that it's really between cold air and hot air that the mix of both of them creates a storm. And they said, look, if we can stop the water rising from the ocean, then maybe we will be able to stop hurricanes. There were some scientists who said that what we need to do is to drop a nuclear bomb, fly it out there on a cargo airplane, and drop the nuclear bomb in the midst of the hurricane, and then that would dissipate the hurricane. There were other scientists who said maybe if we just put some oil film on the ocean, then that will prevent the water from rising up and creating this storm. And Frank Marks said this. He said, that's not going to work. He said, the reason that we're having more hurricanes is, he says, it's not because it is an act of God. He says, it is because of some of the choices that we are making. And some of us want to sit up here and blame every storm on God, but every storm is not from God. It could be that maybe we are using the world and the earth in the way it was never intended to be. So therefore, when the hurricanes come in our lives, we want to blame it on God, but we need to be thinking about ourselves. And I started thinking about that, and I said to myself, there are some of us, we're in the midst of a storm right now, and some of us want to call it Satan, but sometimes it's the choices that we have made that have created the storms that we're experiencing right now. Oh, give somebody a high five and tell them he's preaching to right now. And how many of you have created your own hurricanes? How many of you have created your own storms? How many of you have messed up and now you're trying to figure out, how am I going to get out of this? Maybe it's because of some of the choices that we have made. When I begin to think about this and think about storms, storms are always with us. In fact, the old preachers used to say it like this, that either you are in a storm or you are what? On your way to a storm, or you're coming out of a storm. Yes, all of us will be in one of those three seasons in our lives. We cannot avoid the storms. Sometimes there are hail storms, and sometimes there are thunderstorms. Sometimes there are ice storms, and sometimes there are tornado storms and lightning storms. Yes, there are snow storms. There are tropical storms and flood storms and hurricane storms. Yes, there are all types of storms. And you know, a few weeks ago when I was away starting to write my book, and I remember that I was there, and I was looking outside of the plane as I was making my way back to Philadelphia. And the truth is really told, yes, I was coming back because I wanted to make it back for my baby girl's birthday, but also I didn't want to get stuck in a storm. And I remember being on the plane, and there was some lightning. Matter of fact, it was this flash of light
that I saw to my left because I was in the row by myself and I was thankful nobody else was near me. And I said to myself, I said, somebody's taking a picture on the plane. But then I saw the lightning flash again, and I looked outside the window, and I could just see lightning flash. And I was in the plane, and I started praying to Jesus like I've never prayed before. And then the captain, he came over the PA system, and he said, I just want y'all to see the light show. I said, I don't find that funny right now. I'm on this plane. I'm in the air, and there's lightning that's taking place, and he's calling it a light show, like this is a circus, Cirque du Soleil, like it's some type of amusement park. I didn't pay to get on this plane to see a light show. I can be in my house and look outside my window. I don't need to be in a plane to see nobody's light show. And then the flight attendant, she came on, she said, I want y'all to look to the left because you normally don't see this. And I said to myself, they've seen this before. And I started to take some notes from them, and I listened to them. The woman, she said, because I want you to understand that the lightning is far away. And I said to myself, if I can see it, it's close. Oh, I wish I had somebody in here today. But one of the things that I've discovered as we were going through the storm is that the plane started to get rocking, and the captain came back over the PA system. He said, don't worry about it. We're going through the storm. And at the meantime, I was a little nervous, but then I started thinking about it. And that's just like our lives, is that every now and then, you can't be focused on what's happening around you. You just got to keep on pressing through your storm, knowing that God is with you, knowing that God is making a way. Is there anybody here today that you think God that has helped you make it through the storms? And part of this text and why it's so important is because Jesus wants us to understand that we will always have storms, but if you understand this, and this is very important, is that storms are inevitable. That's the first point I want to share with you today, and I'm going to tweak this point, and they may make some tweaks for me on the screen. Not only are they inevitable, but you can survive the storm if you have the right person in your ship. Oh, I wish I had about five people in here today. You see, you can't do anything about the storm. We can't do anything about these storms, these hurricanes. Matter of fact, even right now, there is Hurricane Larry that is in the Atlantic Ocean. It's already a Category 3 hurricane. We cannot do anything about the storm. But we can do something about who's with us in the midst of the storm. Have I got a witness in here today? Y'all, let me go to the Bible here. The Bible says in verse 35, that day when evening came, he said to his disciples, let us go to the other side. Let me just stop right there. Many of us, we want to go to the other side. Many of us want to receive the promotion. Many of us want the raise. Many of us want the blessing. Many of us, we want the crown. But before you can get the crown, you got to be crucified. Before you can get the promotion, sometimes you got to go through some pain. Before you can be elevated, sometimes you got to go through the valley. But I want to know, is there anybody here today that you're ready to deal with the storms? The Bible says here that when they got ready to go over to the other side, leaving the crowd behind, they took him along just as he was. Beloved, that's shouting news right there. It's because many of us think that when Jesus said, let us go over to the other side, that Jesus, they were following Jesus. No, Jesus simply said, let us go to the other side. But the shouting news is that they took Jesus with him, with them. Oh, I wish I had somebody in here today. If you really got what I was saying, is that when you are about to go to the next level, you better take Jesus with you. When you are getting ready to face your storms, you better take Jesus with you. When God is about to bless you beyond measure, you better take Jesus with you. Because they knew where they were going to the other side, that this particular place was known to create some storms. And that brings me to my second point for today. Not only are storms inevitable, but storms wreak havoc. Come on, put it right there in the chat. Tell your family member who's next to you, storms will wreak havoc. I've never seen a storm that said, I'm going to be nice. Storms do not have a reputation of being kind. I've never seen a hurricane that did not blow wind. I've never seen a tornado that didn't tear up something. Yes, storms, they will wreak havoc. And like many of you, I saw this man as he was walking through his basement. The water was up to his ankles. And he had a camera, I guess, in his basement. As he was walking across his basement, literally just a few seconds later came, and his whole basement wall, y'all see it? It caved in, and all the water started to run in. Yes, storms, they will wreak havoc. Storms will cause challenges. Storms will destroy. Storms will cause pain. Storms will cause headache. Yes, storms will wreak havoc in our lives. But I remember when I was riding and I was driving in the midst of this little tropical storm in August, I heard this woman come over the radio and she said this. She said, because it was hurricane season in the island, she said this. She said, the storm will come and it will destroy. But she said, but life will go on. And I said to myself, I said, she just preached something right there. It's because I'm looking at some people right now. You've been through the storm, but life has kept going on. You may have gotten divorced, but life is still going on. You may have lost your family, or you may have lost your child or your husband, but life still goes on. There are some of you right now, you've been through the valley and you've been through the storms, but thanks be to God that you're still here. Thanks be to God that he keeps on making a way out of no way, because the storms will wreak havoc, but life, it still goes on. But then there's this last thing, and I'm done. Let y'all get to Labor Day. Start getting your grills together. I'll be over around 3 o'clock. And that's this. Not only with storms, they're inevitable. They wreak havoc. But I want you to get this, and I promise you, if you get this, you'll be shouting all around this church. But storms, they don't last always. I said storms, they don't last always. Is there anybody who can testify today that yes, I've been through some storms, but the storms, they don't last always. I don't look like what I've been through, but if you had seen where I was and where I am right now, that storms, they don't last always. Well, I'm almost done. But when you look here in this text, the Bible shares with us that the disciples, they made a good decision by taking Jesus with them in their boat, because they knew that they just might face a storm. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to be on any body of water if I don't have Jesus. You see, this past Wednesday,
when I was here at the church sharing the vision of how God is about to move mightily. And as I was introducing our new campus pastor, Kevin Ruff, the storm started to come through this region. And in fact, we all got that notification, take shelter, because there's a tornado in your region. And I want you to know that this was the first time that I was in the church when the storm came. Oh my God. Many times when a storm comes, I'm at home. But this time I was in the church, and one of my staff members sent around a note and said, it's time to take shelter because the storm is coming. And I said to myself, I'm already in shelter because I'm in the house of God. Have I got a witness in here today? And I just came out here to tell somebody that storms are going to come. But are you in the right place with the right Jesus? Have I got a witness in here today? Every now and then, you've got to have Jesus, because Grandma said he'll walk with you and talk with you and tell you that you are his own. Have I got a witness in here today? And when the storm came, I heard the thunder roll, but I said, I'm all right because I'm in the church with Jesus. Have I got a witness in here today? And that's why you gotta have Jesus when you're going through your valley. That's why you gotta have Jesus when you're going through your storm. That's why you gotta have Jesus when you're going through your midnight. Is there anybody here that wants to take Jesus? I said Jesus. I said Jesus with you in the midst of the storm. Well, you know that there's a such thing as a storm, a surge. A storm surge tears up things. But the Lord blessed me with this. Well, what about a praise, a storm praise? In other words, if the people of God would praise God, they would tear up some things. I dare you right now to look back over your life and to give God some praise. Did he wake you up this morning? It's time for a storm praise. Did he put food on your table? It's time for a storm praise. Did he put clothes on your back? It's time for a storm praise. Give God. I said give God. Give God some praise. It's time for a storm praise. It's not a question if storms will come. It's really a question, who do you have with you in the midst of your storm? And can you give God the praise while you're going through? The doors of the church are open today. There's somebody here as we stand to our feet. And maybe you're online. And maybe you've been trying to figure out, how am I going to make it? How am I going to keep pressing through? And the Bible makes it clear, in order for you to make it through the storm, the Bible says that they took Jesus with them, and they took him as he was. And the Bible says that he was there with them on their boat. Beloved, if you don't have Jesus on your boat, and your boat really represents your life, if you cannot say with assurance that I have Jesus in my life, then why don't you come? If you cannot say with assurance that I have Jesus in my family, why don't you come? Or maybe you are looking for a church, or maybe you're looking for a place where you can grow. I'm here to tell you, storms are going to come. But if you have Jesus, what he'll say to your storms, quiet, be still, peace, be still. If you're here today, why don't you come?
give the hand to the pastor, but give your heart to God, because he is the one who will calm your storms. Why don't you come?
Oh, the Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness.
Bless his name.
The precious blood of Jesus.
That's somebody else, somebody else. Beautiful family. The McKnights. Bless his name. As somebody else. If you're online, why don't you go right there to d2ic.org/join and be a part of what the Lord is doing. Come on. Come on, if you're here in the sanctuary, if you're online, come on. Come on.
Oh, what a Savior. Isn't he wonderful? Sing hallelujah. Christ is risen. Sit, bow down.
Bow down before him.
For he is Lord.
For he is Lord of all.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Christ is
risen.
Oh, what a Savior.
Oh, what a Savior.
Isn't he
just make this appeal one more time. If you're watching online and you're still watching, it could just be that God wants you to go right there. My team, they're typing it right now in the chat. All you have to do is go right there to d2ic.org/join. Click that link and go ahead and join. And if you join today, I'm going to give you a call today to welcome you into our church family. Or if you're here in this sanctuary, you've heard this word and you said, he's preaching to me and I wanted to come forward, just grab the hand of somebody next to you and just squeeze it and say, will you walk with me right now? Will you walk with me right now? Because I don't want you to leave this church today. I don't want you to leave this community today. And you don't have Jesus in your boat or in your family. So they're going to sing one more time. And we invite you now to come. Come on. Come on. Come on online. Come on here in the sanctuary.
Christ is risen.
Family, you can go with Brother Herb, our servant leader. He's going to take you back. I'll be back there shortly. Come on, give them a round of applause. Amen. Matter of fact, do me a favor, Herb, just have them stay, because this is a family of educators, and I want to pray for educators. All educators, will you please come forward? All students, all educators, all administrators. If you work in public schools, higher education, parochial schools, wherever, I want to pray for you right now. I want to pray for your safety and your security. Right now, in the name of Jesus, amen. Come on, let's give it up for all of our students, all of our educators and administrators, amen. Thank you, God, amen. Bless his name. That's almost the whole church. Bless his name, amen. Amen, good sign. Praise God. Let us pray. God, we thank you right now. God, we thank you right now. God, for every student, God, for every educator, for every administrator right now. God, I pray right now for their protection. God, I pray right now in the midst of this COVID-19 season,
God, that you will keep them safe. God, that you will protect them. God, that you will put a hedge of protection around them, oh God. And God, I pray right now, God, that nobody will get sick. Nobody will have to call out, God, that we will have a great year. God, I pray for every educator. God, give them everything that they need, God, to help our students succeed. God, I pray right now for the administrators, God, that they will make wise and sound decisions, God, to help to educate this generation. And then, God, I come praying for parents. God, parents who have lost their mind. God, I pray right now, God, that parents will start to grow up and, God, stop having these stupid fights and battles over wearing a mask. God, we need to wear a mask so that we can be safe. We need to wear a mask so that we can protect one another. We need to wear a mask so that we can show love to one another. God, I pray right now for your blessings. And, God, I declare by the name of Jesus that this is going to be the best year. 2021 is going to be a banner year in the name of Jesus. And all of those who believe, somebody shout hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, stretch out your hands and say with me, life is better when we what? Dare to imagine. God bless you, and let's have a great day. Come on.